Shabbat Torah congregation takes no position by its lay leadership or its professional leadership in anything you're going to hear tonight or anything you've seen. We'd like to thank the Middle East Forum Law Project and the Republican Jewish Coalition in making this a reality this evening. Thank you, Brooke, wherever you're sitting right now. Thank you so much for your help. Steve Leventhal, while I was in Israel, thank you for your help. Hillel Savas, thank you for your help. I'd like to thank the officers of Avot Torah congregation. I know you guys went out on a limb for this, and I appreciate it. And I know, Michelle, it wasn't nice to hear a rabbi calling up, ranting and raving at 3 in the morning Israel time to make sure this happened tonight. Stoughton Police Department, you get a lot of bad press, but I'll tell you, you're 100% with me all the time. Just one quick story, and then I'll turn it over to Hirt. I led a congregational mission, actually a co-mission to Israel. We left February 11th. We arrived in London on February 12th. You all know what happened in London on February 12th? This gentleman was not allowed entry to a fellow EU nation. I was in that airport at that time. It was very interesting. That's all I'll say, very interesting. This gentleman has many connections to one of my favorite causes, if not my favorite cause, the State of Israel. He has visited well over a baker's dozen times. He has even lived in Israel. My relatives heard you speak in Jerusalem this past December. My friends, a hero in my opinion, and this is just my opinion off this pulpit, if ever there was one, Mr. the Honorable Hirt Wilders.
Thank you, my friends, thank you, Rabbi. So much for inviting me. It's an honor and a privilege for me to speak here in this sacred place in Boston. And ladies and gentlemen, I have come to America with a mission because all is not well in the old world. There is a tremendous danger looming. It's difficult, unfortunately, to be optimistic. We might be in the final stages of the Islamization of my continent, of Europe. And this is not only a clear and a present danger to the future of Europe itself, it's also a threat to America and to the sheer survival of the West as well. And I have warned against the dangers of the Quran, against the dangers of the Islam, in numerous interviews, in opinion articles, in speeches, and of course, which is my job, in parliamentary debates. But pictures often say so much more than words. And that, in fact, is why I made my short film, Fitna. I am a lawmaker. I am not a filmmaker, but I felt that I had the duty to educate people about the real nature and the real face of Islam and the Islamization of Europe. A duty to make clear to everyone that the Quran stands at the heart of jihad. I wanted to show that the Quran is not some dusty old book, but that it's still being used today as a source and inspiration for and justification of hatred, of violence, of terrorism across the world. And after the release of the short film Fitna that you just saw, I ended up in a litany of hate speech litigations. Even the most radical imams in my own country, the Netherlands, claimed €55,000 in compensation for his hurt feelings. The most radical imam in Holland. And much Worse than that, the Amsterdam Court of Appeal ordered indeed my criminal prosecution last month because of the reality in the film you just saw. 2 years in jail might be the sentence that I get. And it's not all. Even the state of Jordan, the Kingdom of Jordan, wants to prosecute me because of FITMA and threatens to ask for my extradition. You just saw FITMA. You saw that it's actually not made by me. It is made by Muslim extremists. It is made by the Quran. It is made by the Islam itself. And if FITMA is considered hate speech, then what is the Quran itself? And my mission is to warn people of the Islamization of our Western societies and the devastating effects it will have on our freedom. It has revealed that the degradation of our universal values has already begun. And if there is one country in the world that is most dear to me and that faces the threat of the destruction of the power of Islam, it is Israel. When I was a teenager, I lived in Israel for some years and I visited it numerous times after that. And indeed, last December, I showed my documentary FITMA in Jerusalem, in the city of David, in Israel, the only country in the Middle East with a functioning parliament, with a rule of law, with free elections, the only country in the Middle East that shares the values of our Western societies. But unfortunately, Israel is under threat. As Dr. Samuel Huntington wrote so correctly, he said, Islam has bloody borders. And Israel is located precisely at that border. Tiny Israel is situated on the fault line of jihad. And let nobody fool you. This is not a territorial conflict. It is jihad. And Islam will never have enough until there is no state of Israel. And when that happens, Europe will be next. Israel is simply receiving the blows that are meant for all of us, that are meant for all of the freedom-loving people. And if there would have been no Israel, Islamic imperialism would have found other places to release its energy and its desire for conquest. And therefore, ladies and gentlemen, therefore, the war against Israel is not a war against Israel. It's a war against the West. It is jihad. And thanks to Israeli parents who see their children go off to the army and lie awake at night, parents in Europe can sleep, unaware of the present dangers that are looming. So we have to defend Israel. Not only because we love Israel, but because we have to defend the rest. We all are Israel. We have to defend it, our values, and we have to defend our freedom. And our freedom has already been affected. And to illustrate just how serious the situation in Europe is today, let me tell you a little bit more about my trip to London 2 weeks ago. I had been invited by a member of the British Parliament to speak in the British House of Lords, to show FITMA and have a debate with peers and members of the House of Commons. But indeed, I never reached the House of Lords. Upon arriving at the airport in London, in Heathrow, I was whisked away by immigration officers that explained to me that the British government had denied me entrance in the United Kingdom. They kept me waiting in some kind of cell for several hours before putting me on the next flight home. And what was the reason? What was the reason they gave me for not entering and banning me for the United Kingdom? The reason was, and I quote, "Your presence, because of FITMA, could threaten community harmony," whatever that may mean, "could threaten community harmony and therefore public safety, which of course is total nonsense. Gordon Brown is the biggest coward in Europe today.